It's more than just a game. It's everything. What is your why? Why do you play this game? Why do you love this game? Why will you fight and die for this game? Is it for the championship? Is it for your teammates? Is it for your coaches? Is it for those fans who back you day after day? You are prepared for this game. You know what the other team is doing. You know the game plan. We put the hard work in all year. Now it's time to grind. Now it's time to shine. When you're walking down that tunnel, if you're not going out there to win, don't go out there. You've been waiting your entire life for this moment. And now that it's here, let's show the world we are prepared. We are prepared for war. We are prepared for battle. We are prepared for the enemy on the other side of the field. It doesn't matter who we face. We will fight. We will grind. We will dominate. And we will win. We will win this championship. You've been working. You've been working. And you've been working to defeat them, to destroy them. So don't show any weakness. Don't show any pain. Don't even feel any pain. Now is the time to let them know we will be victors. No one will get in the way of this victory. Brothers, together, I'll fight for you. You fight for me. Together we fight to win. I'm looking for someone that would dare try to stop me. No one can stop me. No one can stop my team. No team will stop us if we stand together. All the hard work we put in will show on the field. The field of battle. Let's go win this championship.
Welcome back to the playoffs, the best time of year.
Here we go. Yeah, it's going down like that, son. You think you're the best?
I think this crowd is ready for hockey. Sit back and enjoy this one.
You're looking at it. The best of the best. Best there is. Enjoy the show.
Let's get ready to rumble in the jungle. Got the ball to the
hockey. Shoots, he scores. And Aaron scores.
Man, oh, man. Austin Matthews spins out one. Along the goal line and the in.
That was awesome.
McDavid to Draisaitl. Scores. Will the Yossi back get in? Mark Messer goes in. Oh, my goodness gracious.
What is worth my word is burned.
Shining.
You never won a trophy until you won this, and I don't know how to describe it.
I'm so numb right now, I don't know what to say.
When you were a kid, is it like what you dreamed of?
My greatest moment in the history.
We all have dreams. Fantastic moments. And milestones that live only in our minds. But dreams don't become reality all on their own. They must be shaken awake.
For the Stanley Cup, I think you risk everything.
This is what it takes to win the Stanley Cup.
12 stitches in the head.
Tirelessly.
Probably the most emotionally and physically draining thing I've ever been a part of.
For years. For a lifetime.
We have too many guys that have sacrificed their whole career, and this is the time.
I appreciate it a heck of a lot more when it takes you 16 years.
22 years. You did it.
Drenched in sweat, in tears.
You gotta go through some of this to win.
Those are the horrible moments. Those are the bad times. It's all worth it now. God damn it, it's all worth it.
And even the greatest ones knew that forging silver from ice can't be done alone.
The temperature has reached a boiling point.
He scores!
These guys are dream makers, one and all.
Assistants in Charlie McAvoy and David Pastrnak, as they will be on the ice and Marchand will be watching.
So once again, the Bruins without their leading point scorer so far in the postseason, Callie, and they have had a tough time generating offense. So again, without Marchand, where does it come from?
It has to come from the center ice position if you're me. And listen, going into this season, they lost Krejci and they lost Bergeron. The center ice position was a big question mark for Boston. So coming into this game, I look at Charlie Coyle and Pavel Zacha are two guys that need to step up and provide some much needed offense if Boston wants to not be eliminated.
The Bruins trying to keep their season alive. The Panthers one step away from the conference finals. We'll drop the puck. Game five is next.
Barkov into the slot, makes a move, shot, he scores! Barkov, what a move! He scores! Pastrnak, power play goal!
You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs on ESPN, presented by Geico. The Florida Panthers, one win away from eliminating the Boston Bruins. We're set to drop the puck in game five. There's nothing like playoff hockey.
In Boston, we specialize in long memories. Yeah, we remember last year.
Tell me, do you want to hear the story unfold? Because I'm not turning out to be the villain you know.
This is the Stanley Cup playoffs. It can either heal your pain or smash open old wounds.
These are two teams that are rivals. It's gonna be a series.
The Panthers are built for this.
And the Panthers take a 3-1 lead.
But the Bruins are built on toughness.
I'm not afraid of him, you know. It's a sauce for everybody.
It's difficult to imagine the pressure, but it is impossible to feel more alive.
Rivalries are developed in the playoffs, and there is certainly a rivalry that has been developed between the Boston Bruins and the Florida Panthers. We're just about set to get game five started. Right now, let's join the public address announcer, Andrew Imber, here in Sunrise.
Please rise and remove your caps as the United States Navy Honor Guard presents our nation's colors. Here to perform the Star Spangled Banner, please welcome Geraldine Martin.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the
once again, Geraldine Martin and the United States Navy Honor Guard.
Bob Bushues and Ryan Callahan and Leah Hextall set for puck drop between the Panthers and the Bruins here in Game 5 and trying to put this series away. And one in tonight, Kelly, will be Sergei Bobrovsky.
Yeah, he's going to have to be good tonight, appearing in his 27th straight playoff game for the Florida Panthers. So they look to Bob to be good in net to move on in the playoffs.
And Jeremy Swayman, no more than 2 goals allowed in his first 7 starts in the postseason, but now 12 goals allowed in his last 3.
Yeah, he's going to have to be at his best. There's no question about that. Established himself as the number one guy here in Boston. Has to prove it tonight.
Callie, they always say, and you would know, the hardest win to get in a 7-game series is the last one, because obviously the Bruins will be playing with desperation tonight.
And you said it, desperation and urgency. They realize they're one loss away from going home and ending their season. It's hard to manufacture that for the Florida Panthers when you're up 3-1, but look for this Panthers team to do that.
And the exact...
Quickly send a message that home sweet home is overrated, Cheryl.
It is in this case, and what a quick start for the away team. This is exactly what they wanted to do. They're up one with under a minute into the game, and wow, now their home team is chasing the game.
Oh, how did they keep it out? What a blocker stop by Swayman! Fires it! Oh, misses the net! What a chance there!
Oh, it was a great chance, and one that he will want back. The puck is all around him, though. If he continues to get to the right spot at the right time, you gotta figure he's gonna put one by the Tendy.
McAvoy's the key blue liner, not just because he defends so well, but because he can add additional offense. Barkov is known for picking his opponent's pockets with his short zone ability. Those takeaways can lead to offensive attacks. Now, these are impact players, and I'm expecting one of them to leave their mark on this one here tonight. Now, let's send it back upstairs.
Bobrovsky's gonna hang on for a whistle.
Pasternak's best scoring chances come from when he's shooting the puck when it's flat and settled on the ice. He has great accuracy, and we call that his snipe zone ability.
Florida's got it in the defensive zone. Working the puck deep inside their own end. Boston's got possession at center. Moves it to Coyle. Takes a spill onto the ice and loses the puck. Florida's moving it along the wing. Great pressure on the offensive end by Tarasenko. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Loose puck battle along the boards. Couldn't catch up to that pass. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Boston's got it across the line. Moves it quickly over to Van Riemsdyk. Bennett's got the puck in his own zone. Went for the dirty dangle and it goes sideways. Oh, sensational stop with the stick by Swayman!
You have to be quick in your crease if you want to be able to deny low zone shots. He does that perfectly as he's tight to the shooter right there.
And that's knocked away in the defensive end by Bennett. DeBrusk's got it in the defensive end. Grabs the puck at center. Boston's on the attack. Let's it go! And there's the save on the play. Takes a shot. Off a stick. Takes the feed at the point. With the blast! Denies him! He got all of it! Ref blows the whistle as the puck's covered up. Past the midway mark in this period. Boston's up 1-0. And they take possession here in the offensive zone, and time to go on the attack. Stopped by the goaltender, getting a piece of that one. Quick pass to Kiki. Great save by Bobrovsky. Boston's got it behind the net. Here's a chance in front. Takes a shot. Scores! And they run it back with another.
Yeah, back-to-back goals. You can feel the energy, the wave, the momentum, and the tides have turned here, James. They need to keep the pedal to the metal. Well, he fought for position to find this puck on his backhand, James. He's running out of real estate, but he was able to put it through and find the netting.
Boston's come to play tonight, now leading by two here in the first.
Well, a consistent effort through the first period here, James. I'll just want to wind it down and make sure they head to intermission with that two-goal lead. But it's all about the number of shots they're putting towards the net. You know that their coach has been telling them. You get it on your stick, you find a lane, put it there.
Puck picked up by Ekblad. And he takes the feed. Quick feed to Kiki. And that's broken up in the defensive zone by Forsling. What a steal in his own end. Carries it in. And change is coming up front as the puck is sent in deep. The Bruins will play it from the defensive zone. Textbook stop by Bobrovsky. Takes the feed at center. Back to the blue line. Forces the turnover in the defensive zone.
The Bruins have been picking off passes left, right, and center. You know the coach is going to like this, but it has to transition to offense because this game's awfully close.
Listen up, fans. For tonight only, all team jerseys are 15% off regular price with the presentation of your ticket stub. Get yours.
Second period set to get underway. Second frame is underway as the puck is dropped. Well, Cheryl, already a third of this one played. What do you make of this one?
The Panthers with a flat start to that opening frame, James. They really didn't manage the puck. It was real sloppy and scrambly, and they're going to have to find a way to correct that if they want to get back in this game.
Penalty coming up here.
That'll always be a call. If you extend your arms and cross-check, you're serving two.
Chance to get on the power play for the first time this evening.
First power play opportunity of the game. You know they've worked on this in practice. The setup, the look that they want. Let's see how they move the puck around the perimeter and look to attack.
The Bruins cross the blue line and are on the attack. Florida's looking to break out of their own end. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. There's the whistle as the play was offside. Hope everyone's enjoying the game here tonight. Another big face-off here on this power play. And with the two centers tangled up, the winger skates away with it.
Freeze the puck!
Bobrovsky's got the puck and he's gonna hang on. Holmquist ready for the draw as they will continue to try to kill off this penalty. Off, they take the puck. Verhaeghe's stick handling in his own zone. Moves around along the half wall. And now he tries to get it across to Verhaeghe. From the left side, it moves to the middle of the ice. The Bruins have possession shorthanded. Oh, he'll feel that one. Great use of the stick at center by Ekblad. And the power play comes up empty. Both teams back to even strength. Oh, what a save in front!
Bobrovsky's made himself look big on that save and almost made it look easy. That's a high shooting percentage shot because it's coming from a grade-A scoring area.
Finds it to the crease! And too much traffic in front knocks that one. Came up with a nice save. And now he moves it quickly to Ekblad. Tarasenko's gonna play it against the half wall. Denies that opportunity. And offside, we'll get a reset here. what preaching, lots of shots on net, and they have done it and lead as a result here in the second. The Bruins win the draw. Pass stolen in the open ice. The Panthers carry it along the wall. Good fight for the puck along the boards. Trying to shake the defender. Across the line. Oh, it stayed out. Oh, my goodness, what a stop. What a stop.
Let's have a look at that last save again. It was absolutely incredible. You're under pressure. You're under attack. Really under siege, and you find a way to get to the puck. This is the stop that champions are made of.
The Panthers have it from their own end. Opposals across the line now and on the attack in the offensive end. The Bruins scoop it up along the boards.
Go, go, go!
The Panthers will play it in their own end. Through the neutral zone now, picking up steam. And it's a quick pass to Ekman Larson. Oh, that's a smart heads-up play as he breaks it up with the poke. Centering feed! And he denies that great opportunity there. Well past the midway mark of this period, the Bruins are currently sitting in the driver's seat leading 2-0. Bostic's won it, now they'll go on the attack. And that goes off a player in front. Kulikov's lugging the puck. Quick feed to Ekman Larson. Receives the pass. Shot! Oh, great save right there on the play. Streaking through center, they go on the attack. Sends the pass in front! The Bruins continue to lead here in the late stages of this second period. Puck is dropped, play resumes. The Bruins take it along the wall. Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Oh, pass save! Tremendous agility there by Bobrovsky. Just here in the late stages of this frame, and it's a 2-0 hockey game. The Bruins win that offensive zone faceoff. Florida's got it in their own zone. The Bruins get a hold of it. Boston's got it along the wall. Moves into the slot. How did he stop that one?
Does a great job with some great pushes to get to the top of his crease and make the save from a high danger area.
The buzzer, two periods down, one more to go. They always say three is the magic number. We've got period number three next.
Download our free app today and start earning great rewards. In March, hold on your ticket today to earn points for attending tonight's game.
Welcome back to EA Sports, the final frame of this one. Here we go. Period number three is underway as the puck is dropped. Well, with two periods played, Pounder, your thoughts?
The Panthers have been back on their heels throughout this entire game. The good part, they got 20 minutes left to play, and it's a close game. They got to find an opportunity to get a shot off, James, and that means generating speed, generating offense, and you'll only start if they can get into the offensive zone.
Ekblad's taking it from his own end. The Panthers have it in the offensive zone. And there's the save. Here's a short pass to Tarasenko. Through the neutral zone, up along the wing. Picked up along the wall by Pastrnak. Shot it through! Scores! And that's three unanswered goals. And as my mom likes to say, they're cooking with gas.
They're cooking with gas. And you can expect that they have put their opponents on their heels. This is a team that knows. Well, you create offense by moving the puck, and that's exactly what he does here. He knows how to manipulate his opponent to open up the lane, but it's all about the pass. It's got to be on the money if you want to do something with it.
The Bruins have built themselves a sizable lead here early in this third period. The Panthers win the faceoff. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check, and he loses control of the puck. DeBrusk's got it across the line. Here's a feed in front. What a chance, but they can't connect. Quick pass across to Reinhardt. And now it's over to Rodriguez. It's up for along the boards. The Bruins have it now. Here they come. Moves it to the middle. Great defensive play to kick off the pass. And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Here comes the call.
Coaches hate stick infractions. They're real frustrating. You're right there. You're in and around the puck. You go fishing and you wind up in the box.
Back to the face-off circle. They'll send the man advantage in and out again.
Power plays, more time on the ice. The ability to get that puck moving. These players know exactly what they're doing. They work on it in practice. Spoke to some of them earlier today at the pregame, and they talked about the execution and the precision in particular with their puck movement.
Shot, and that goes off course off of Bonnie. Tremendous stop by Bobrovsky.
Now the shooter's going to run out of real estate because he does a great job of getting out of top of the crease and taking away all the room. When you make yourself as big as possible, there's less holes in the net.
Made the stop on the play. My goodness, the pressure really building here on the offensive end. And the D's got it here. Along the half wall with the puck. And that's intercepted by Shattenkirk. Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. And a solid effort by the penalty killers as we are back to even strength. Big time stop!
That power play wasn't very good, James. Just really slow and methodical, an easy read for the PK unit. You gotta fight to find something in the middle ice and get some shots on net.
Boston's been way more active here tonight on the ice, and they have certainly capitalized on their opportunities and continue to lead in the third. Puck is dropped, and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Boston's looking to break out. Through center. Hooked away as he went all in on that one. And they go back on the attack in the offensive zone.
Looks, James, you have to have timing and an awareness to be able to get your stick on that rebound and then bury it. Not a lot of time and space available, but he executes perfectly.
Boston's added yet another one here to the total tonight. I mean, what a performance.
Yeah, they've had the puck on their stick for a majority of this game. You know the coaching staff is going to be impressed. Hey, maybe they'll get the day off tomorrow.
Puck grabbed by Edmund Larson. The Panthers played along the wing. Here's a chance in front. Oh, and he keeps it here. Moves it to Kulikov. Now a quick pass to Reinhardt. Here's a shot. Oh, and he steps up with the glove to stop that one. Cuts into the paint. Oh, a clutch save. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Rodriguez. Great puck save! Handles the pass. Straight feed! And that's stopped! Still has possession. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. Van Riemsdyk's got it along the boards. The Panthers get a hold of the puck in the open ice. Moves it quickly over to Barkov. Scrub along the wall. And that's all she wrote on this one as we are in the books. Well, somebody's clearly not ready to go home just yet here, Cheryl. Big win tonight to make it a 3-2 series.
Another response game, James. I mean, they're staring down elimination. They put together a great performance to get it done. You're their opponent. Listen, you got to be getting nervous. You keep saying to yourself, listen, we got to get it done. We got to get it done. So the mindset is starting to shift here. And the next game, it's going to be a good one.
Well, that'll do it for tonight's postseason action, but the playoffs roll on, and we will see you at the next game. From all of us here at EA Sports, I'm James Cebulski. Good night.